we may have officially entered a recession. On Friday, August 2nd, the markets experienced one of its worst sell-offs again, but this time, almost no equity sector was safe. After the release of some crucial economic data, the market narrative shifted from a soft landing to fears over a hard landing and a recession. Investors are now extremely concerned that the Federal Reserve waited too long to start cutting interest rates. And right now, there's a chance that interest rate cuts will happen at a much faster pace than first expected, which is telling us that the central bank is very concerned about the state of the economy, pricing in a 22% chance of a 50 basis point cut instead of a 25 basis point cut by September. And we urgently need to talk about everything that has happened, as well as cover some of the best ETFs that investors can use to hedge against this coming recession. If you guys are enjoying this content and find it helpful, please do me a little favor and hit that thumbs up button for the YouTube algorithm. It really helps out my channel and I really appreciate it. So thank you guys so much. Let's move on. On Friday, the S&P 500 fell 2%, the Nasdaq 100 fell 3%, and the Dow was down 2%, and big tech stocks like Microsoft, Nvidia, Broadcom, ASML, and Google suffered major downside pressure, falling between 2 to 8%. Dividend ETFs like SCHD and VYM fell around 2%. Frankly, every equity sector suffered major selling pressure. But fixed income bonds and ETFs like TLT were amongst the only investments that saw major price appreciation. And TLT, which focuses on long-duration bonds, rallied by 3% on Friday. And if you recall, TLT was one of the ETFs that I chose for a 3-ETF portfolio that was strictly for the purpose of mitigating portfolio risk in case of a potential recession. And I'll circle back to that in just a second. Now, the most shocking thing that happened on Friday was the insane spike in volatility reaching a peak of over 50%. The last time we saw the volatility index rise 50% in a single day was during the bear market of 2022. And my concern is that there's still a lot more volatility to come, so the probability of hitting a 100% spike is very likely. Looking at the VIX term structure chart, we haven't even hit the peak volatility that has been priced in for October. So I think this is a major warning right now. So what happened? Why have the markets all of a sudden changed gears and started preparing for a recession? What sparked major fears for investors was the release of crucial economic data that can be divided into two separate events. Now, earnings did also play a role, but the economic data is what caused investors to change gears. On Thursday, August 1st, ISM manufacturing PMI data was released. And manufacturing data is one of the big four recession indicators. This data is a leading indicator of the overall health of the manufacturing sector, which is a significant component of the economy as it covers things like supply chain and employment. A PMI above 50 indicates expansion in the manufacturing sector, while a PMI below 50 indicates contraction. And on Thursday, we saw a very poor reading of only 46, coming in well below estimates. But the biggest concern here was the rapid drop. When this happens, that means that businesses are expecting much lower demand, which can lead to reduced production and, consequently, slower economic growth. And what's very concerning is that if you look all the way back to the recession in 2009, almost the exact same thing happened, where manufacturing PMI suddenly fell sharply downwards and then continued for an extended period of time. So this was the first sign of a potential hard landing, which resulted in heavy selling pressure in the markets. But on Friday, the markets received another set of disappointing economic data that sparked even more fear, and that is unemployment data, which unfortunately came in much higher than expectations. Analysts were estimating a 4.1% unemployment rate, which would be in line with last month's reading, but unfortunately, we saw a sharp increase to 4.3%. And unemployment is again one of the big four recession indicators. High unemployment is a key sign of contraction in the economy as people have less money to spend, decreasing consumer spending, negatively impacting retail sales, which has a negative effect on business and business growth, and ultimately impacting economic growth. An analyst was quoted stating that an increase in unemployment threatens to take on a life of its own, weighing on consumer spending, causing more layoffs, and igniting a negative self-reinforcing cycle. Watch if consumers turn more cautious. If they do, the economic expansion is at a significant risk. The Fed has made a mistake in not cutting interest rates already. Hopefully, it isn't an existential mistake. So all of this together brings to light heavy recession fears. And I think the biggest shocker in all of this was how rapidly the economic data went south. Many investors were hoping that earnings season would spark some enthusiasm, but unfortunately, majority of what we saw was big tech companies spending billions of dollars on AI and AI development, which has not proven to be profitable whatsoever. So when you combine poor earnings with very shocking and disappointing economic data, you get a very fearful and highly volatile market. And that is why the volatility index spiked over 50% on Friday. Now, my number one source of economic data, comparison charts, fund details, market updates, and finding a strong investment is Seeking Alpha, and I highly, highly suggest to use this platform. And right now, you guys can get $25 off their premium plan by using my link in the description down below. And I'm also super excited to announce a new feature that they rolled out, which are investing groups. And these groups give you direct access to Seeking Alpha's expert analysts that create model portfolios, regular stock picks, sell and buy notifications, and provide exclusive investor resources. I myself am in two of these groups, which are the Growth Investor Pro and the Dividend Freedom Tribe. If you guys want to get access to these groups and check it out for yourself, there are also many other groups available, then you can get 20% off your membership by using my link in the description down below. Now back to the video. It's important to mention two catastrophic earnings that were reported on Friday, which gave investors added fear of economic contraction. The first was Amazon. Amazon reported their earnings after hours on Thursday, and the results were a little mixed. They had a revenue miss of $700 million below estimates. There were a few things in combination which sparked concerns for investors, and it all primarily revolves around slowing growth projections, ultimately causing more than a 10% sell-off in Amazon stock. Net sales in the online store segment grew at a very slow rate at only 5% year over year, and this was down significantly from last year. Advertising services, which grew at a solid 24% year over year last year, is trending to grow 4% this year. And subscription services, which grew 14% year over year last year, is trending to grow 8% this year. So I think Amazon's earnings was a key indication of a slowdown in consumer spending, which ties perfectly into rising unemployment rates. Simply put, people are spending less money. But of course, Amazon did have very strong AWS revenue, which cushioned its slowing growth in all the other segments. But nonetheless, a revenue miss is not what analysts were expecting, so the stock fell sharply lower. Now, another earnings report that sparked some major concerns was Intel, and to say that it was a disaster would be an understatement. Intel stock plummeted nearly 30% on Friday, marking its worst sell-off since 1974. The company is going through so much trouble right now that they are going to be cutting 15% of their workforce, which is around 17,000 people. And they are eliminating their dividend. And right now they are scrambling to implement as many cost-cutting tactics as possible, especially because the company is suffering from dropping margins thanks to artificial intelligence. Oh, and let's not forget that the US has now launched an antitrust probe into Nvidia over sales practices. Competing companies have filed complaints that Nvidia is abusing its market dominance in selling AI chips, pressuring cloud providers to buy more Nvidia products. And honestly, I had a feeling this was going to happen because anytime a company has a monopoly over anything, there are going to be some investigations taking place, which unfortunately will have some potential negative implications for the stock. So what does this mean for investors today? What are some of the best ETFs to hedge against this recession? And what can we expect moving forward? I have been warning about the implications of rate cuts and how it can lead to a recession for a few weeks now. You have to remember that rate cuts are used to stimulate economic growth in order to avoid going into a recession. But if the situation of the economy deteriorates faster than expected, then they will be forced to implement more rate cuts at a faster pace. You see, interest rates were used to counteract rising inflation, and the Federal Reserve kept it high strictly as a means of getting inflation back down to target levels. And the hopes were that the Federal Reserve would get inflation under control and then start cutting interest rates before the economy started to deteriorate, hence a soft landing. But honestly, when you look at the past recessions, the hopes and patterns occurred every single time. Interest rates were raised for an extended period of time, and then once rate cuts were implemented, the economy would go into a recession. Even in the recession of 2008, analysts were talking about a soft landing, just like they have been in the past 2 years. Now, I always look at the yield curve or the 10-year minus 3-month yield spread chart because this has been a reliable recession indicator. And I will go over this in more detail in my next video because there are some major details that we have to discuss. And it all revolves around the inverted yield curve. Every time the yield curve or the yield spread reverted back to positive, or in other words, interest rate cuts occurred, a recession followed promptly. That is why when I created the 3 ETF portfolio example, I made sure to include an ETF that is able to directly benefit from interest rate cuts, and that is TLT. TLT is an ETF that invests in long-duration bonds with maturity dates exceeding 20 years. And long-duration bonds are highly sensitive to interest rates. But most importantly, they have an inverse relation. So when interest rates fall, the value of these bonds will increase and vice versa. And right now, given that rapid rate cut expectations have increased, the value of this ETF can skyrocket. In every past recession where we saw interest rates get cut, the value of this ETF increased significantly, which served as a perfect hedge for investors. And in yesterday's sell-off, almost every single equity sector suffered except for the bond sector. And right now, I think that this trend will likely continue. Now, I will be making another video that goes over other ETFs in detail because aside from TLT, utility ETFs like XLU also performed relatively well as these are known to be defensive investments. But for now, be careful out there because volatility is likely going to get even worse. And that is all for this one. If you haven't yet, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the thumbs up button for the YouTube algorithm. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next one.